The catch has never been the same for fishermen on Lake Albert. Stefan Mbidi has been in the business for years and attests to the declining numbers thanks to a variety of challenges.
It's shared between two countries, that's DRC and Uganda. So in most cases, the challenge we get, the DSC security team sometimes come in a pound of nets, Uganda take them there, and boats. Getting them becomes very expensive for the poor fishermen. And even sometimes, when we are conserving with them, they're not conserving. At the end of it all, you find them with them, they enter here into our waters and end up harvesting what we are conserving.
It's the same story for Seremosi Kamtarachi, who now struggles to make ends meet.
The other challenge is that fishermen, whereas they were, their equipments were broken, were burnt by the enforcement team, there is no kind of support from government.
The State Minister for Fisheries, Helena Doa, says the country is currently experiencing a challenge of fish stockouts because some of the enforcement officers have given chances to wealthy businessmen to harvest immature fish. The minister has termed them greedy.
The challenge that we are having also is there are some greedy individual Ugandans who have now shifted their greed, their corruption to the lake, where they take immature fish, load in lorries, load in trailers, load in box vehicles, and take to sell.
Adoa further revealed that some of the corrupt officials are very connected, but the ministry will not overlook them. She has called on the fishing community to safeguard the lake since it's their main source of livelihood.
Because the lake, the stocks are going down, the lake has been destroyed by greedy individuals who have been protected. And these individuals are so powerful and connected. When you try to touch them, instead they blackmail you, they tarnish your name, and they want to see that they snare you in order to keep their grip.
The Bulisa Resident District Commissioner, Longino Bahewa, says fish cage farming could also reduce the pressure on the lake. He, however, reveals that some of those that had been started were washed away by the 2021 floods. He requests for the government's intervention.
Some farmers who had the fish cages, but later they were submerged by water, and as most of them were destroyed. So our request is, if the ministry really want, we have organized fish farmers, if they can again help them by providing fish cages, so that at least we promote fish caging farming.
But now we are coming up to sensitize the fishing communities, sensitize the people, that we should only capitalize on only those fishing methods that are going to be, that are targeting only good fish.
The Bulisa District Man Member of Parliament, Nora Bigira, wants the government to put in place harmonious policies that will put an end to the challenges on the lakes like piracy on Lake Albert.
It is important to understand and also good at this very moment that most of the countries within which we share the water bodies are now under ESC. Can we come up at this point in time to have policies that are harmonious to address the challenges that we have on our water body?
The Fisheries Day was marked under the theme Promoting Responsible Fishing Methods for Improved Household Incomes and Livelihoods. Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomuza for the news.